Good morning, people of Twitch. Fuck's sake. Stupid camera's in the wrong position. Damn. Not better. Nope. Not quite. Yeah, that's it now. There we go. So yes, hello Twitch. It's Pants. Excuse me. Yeah, I'm playing more Eve. I'm currently on the grind to attempt to afford a thingy. Bigger ship. Cruiser. Yes, that's the next step. I have the skills trained already for, well, most of the necessary skills trained already anyway. Namely, the actual cruiser skill. There. Oh, it's only at 1. Shit. No, we'll need to be resolving that. That needs to go to 3. Holy crap, that takes fucking ages. I'll tame you till tomorrow. At 1 o'clock. Son of a bitch. So, yes, I can actually fly a cruiser, just not got it particularly high up in the skill-wise yet. Ideally, you want your shit at 3 to do stuff. You know what? I think I might take that one off. Shit. I don't know what to do with my skills. I know I need to upgrade my shield skills. They need to go to a minimum of 3 on each, preferably. They've got a better training time. 14, 7. 10 and 7, Jesus. Right, I want cruiser up first. I think by the time about a day passes, probably have cruisers done. I'll have bought one, rather. Targeting skills could be doing the going up a bit. It's so difficult to decide. I haven't got any drone skills. Fucking wasp, it's back again. I swear to God, the last 3 days we've had the same wasp coming in the windows in our house. A big bastard too. It's fairly harmless, right enough. Morning, Betty, how are you? But yeah, it's not a particularly hostile wasp. It just pisses about over at the windows and then buggers off again after a little while. But yeah, let's see. Weird. Yeah, chased it out this morning. Chased it out yesterday, twice. And the day before that, I chased it out. Must be 3 or 4 times. We can't really have the windows not open, because it's far too warm to not have the windows open. I don't know what it's doing, though. I wonder if it just likes the vape residue that's left on the windows or something. You know how when you vape, the vapor stuff can sort of condense on the windows a bit. It seems to be floating around the sort of bits with more sort of condensation on. That's probably what it is. Anyway, yeah. Fuck the skills. We'll do for just now. And I'll just get out and get more money so that I can actually buy a cruiser. Right, what am I needing to do? Fly to the coordinates, eliminate the vessels, recover the prisoners. Okay, sounds straightforward enough. It's in the same system, so I don't need to fly about too much. Where the fuck's that gone? Never mind. There we go. Why is it whenever I sit down at the computer and the throat starts going? Ah, pardon, Betty.
Hello.
How you getting on the day?
Oh, fine. Where did you... Why have you got a bounty?
Somebody was trolling the rookie channels and decided to put a bounty on me for some reason. I don't know.
Tempting. But yeah, you're not
it's
worth
not
it.
It's not worth it. Totally. 100,000. That's pesh.
Although it would have been humorous me showing up in a caracal and going, hello! Womp. But no, because I don't think he's turned friendly fire off in the corporation.
No, it's friendly fire is off for the corporation. Son of a bitch.
Well, I zipped around yesterday and picked up most of the struggling around the place bits of equipment.
Cool.
I'm set for working for a corporation.
Uh-huh.
I can have up to 3 jump clones.
Cool.
I was looking at my skills last night, and I'm like, it'd be really handy to have clones in various places. And I had a look, and I'm like, oh, I can have 3. I must, because I've got the scientist background, I trained up a load of skills that were quick to train, I think. So I've ended up with lots of jump clone stuff.
Nice.
Yeah. That's quite handy.
Installed EVEMON as well on my computer, so I can keep an eye on things when I'm not actually in the game.
I put one on my phone instead.
Aura, by any chance?
Can't remember, and I can't look because my phone's plugged in as my webcam just now, so yay.
I've got 6 hours left to go on missile projection rank 4.
Not bad.
Then I'm going to work on some of the, I've got queued the exploration stuff.
Yeah.
What I've mainly been doing, of course, is reading lots. Well, I say I'm all packaged up now and ready to go, which is a bonus.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, looking at the quickest course, yeah, there's a lot of very busy systems en route.
Yeah, there will be.
Because you're going through the core.
Uh-huh.
Core of the Caldari space. Oh yes, and the Caracal, to begin with, because even the level I'm at, I'll probably just go with 2 heavy missile launchers and 3 lights.
Oh, okay. Are you still at sort of level 2 mission type?
Yeah.
Aye, that's probably more
so.
Sensible.
Yeah. The heavies are useful against, because as you discovered, you come across bigger ships.
You do occasionally, yeah. Not too many of them.
And you're sitting there shooting loads and loads of your light missiles. So I'm like, nah, have a couple of the, at least 1 heavy launcher.
Mm-hmm.
I'm considering rapid launchers.
That's the assault launchers, yeah.
Yeah. For the light, It's like, oh no, they hold less ammo. What a shame.
I know.
No. If I've got 4 of them, it wouldn't really matter, though.
Yeah.
Well, that plus the fact I've got drones as well, so, yeah.
Aye, true.
Go in and massacre things.
Yep. This one isn't too bad.
It's not as if I'm going to run out of missiles in a hurry.
No, I do try and make sure I get plenty of missiles.
Well, you've got to find the balance between how many you have around the place. Because, if you're not using them up quick enough, that's money you've spent.
Yeah.
For no reason.
Indeed.
So, well, in my case, since I made all the missiles I'm using, it's not too bad. But yes, I shall possibly start drifting. You're in and around the forge, aren't you?
Yeah, that's right. I'm in perimeter.
So yeah, I might head in your direction. You can escort me possibly down to. I think you're 3 or 4 jumps away from where I am.
All right.
That's all. Yeah.
You haven't got far to go then. Oh, right. And are you heading for the corporation headquarters, though?
For the corporation headquarters is 10 jumps beyond that, yeah.
Right, okay.
Or whatever. So, yeah. So, I don't want to get bounced and lose all my stuff. I'm not insane. Although, if it was people trying to bounce us in frigates, that would be a huge mistake. Because even my Badger's
pretty deal good with at
defending itself. Well, I've got the missile launcher and the turret on it, so yeah. And the turret's got the particularly nasty ammunition loaded.
Mm-hmm.
Like shields? What shields? But yes. So I've started my skill queue at least.
Yeah.
And yeah. So it is very tempting to go for the rest of the cheap offer. And get another 150 days cheap game time.
I'd see, this is it. I quite like these offers and stuff, but I never really end up playing. See, once I've paid for something, I like to use the time because it's, you know, it's more sensible and efficient and shit. So.
But you see, I'm one of these people that, well, because I don't work, and I'm an insomniac, I have an awful lot of free time. How do you think I got so reasonable at World of Warships?
Yeah, indeed.
Oh, there was a patch for that today.
Was there?
Yeah.
All right.
Just a little one. Fixing some of the issues that the last patch caused. You know, the usual online game thing.
Fuck yeah, indeed.
I was looking at e-forums.
Uh-huh.
I can't believe it. It's 10 years on and people are still bitching about daily downtime. I'm like...
I know, for goodness sake. It's off for like 5-10
servers ever go down. I mean, they had that huge battle a couple of years back.
Mm-hmm.
And the server slowed, but it still didn't crash.
Mm-hmm.
And there's, was it 40,000 people taking part in a mass battle?
Yep.
No other game can do that.
No. Although the way they do it is quite clever with that whole time dilation thing.
Yeah.
That's quite smart.
Yeah, it's the game with the most uptime, and you still have people complaining about the downtime.
Yeah. Like,
get over it.
Some people are just never fucking happy.
Hard drives and components wear out. They have to do maintenance.
They have to sort shit out now and again, totally.
Yeah. Because, the last thing you want to do is be trying to change one of the RAID drives while the server's live, for instance.
Indeed.
Because while technically it is possible, it's not usually a good idea. I mean, banks have downtime every night.
Every so often.
And they're online banking. So.
Well, I mean, this is it. I mean, there's you'd get hot swap drives and stuff, so, you know.
Yeah. But it's still a good idea powering down.
Aye, to swap it.
Whichever bit it is you're switching.
Mm-hmm. Oh god, these industrial ships just take forever to blow up.
Yeah, I think that's another reason why I was doing turreted ships. you're faster at taking down the big ships.
Yeah, even with little turrets, it's more consistent damage.
Yeah.
Not necessarily more, but certainly makes it feel quicker.
Well, since I have a penchant for using antimatter and phased plasma, yeah, I think I was killing things pretty quick. Yeah, with the two types of ammo, you're wrecking shields and hull simultaneously. So, yes.
I could probably do that and use EM missiles in one set and then hull-pounding missiles in another, but honestly, it's too much effort.
The complexities get... Yeah, it's nice that it's a detailed game and you can do all these great things, but yeah...
I think when you get to a certain point, it's probably worth doing, but I think at this stage it's probably not.
Yeah, because that's one of the options I could have with the Caracal, is put EM in the heavy launcher. And then if I do come across a big ship, well, you take out a shield with a big launcher and nuke them with the little ones. Yeah, Wanderer's saying, yeah, you can switch to rockets for more damage per second.
Yeah.
But
I like being able to shoot stuff from miles away.
Yeah, fire and forget has its advantages.
It does. It's one of the... I found that I'd like to use rockets, but missiles are more effective at taking out... Well, when I'm in the destroyer, at least.
Yeah.
Missiles are more effective at taking out bigger ships like cruisers and stuff, because you can keep... I can keep at range, like, 40-odd kilometres where they can't really hit me. But I can pound on them. But because it takes so long with, sort of, light missiles to do, it feels safer. I am really tempted to try out the rockets, though, to be honest.
Yeah. Very good for doing barrage work.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Get nice and close and just unload fucking tons of damage very quickly. But yeah, I don't know how long I'd survive having to go up close to cruisers and shit, though.
Yeah, it's not worth it until you get a cruiser yourself.
Right, so that was that mission. That was nice and...
Because, yeah, the minute you're sort of still set up for solo play, so...
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, the last time I went...
So the missiles make it more convenient in many ways. Yes.
The last time I went toe-to-toe with cruisers, I died very quickly.
Oh, yeah. Well, they're designed to take out destroyers, so yeah.
But yes, I must have... I am thoroughly fucking tempted to go, rockets.
Oh, I mean, sometimes when I remember doing missions where it's, as you say, missile turrets and hard structures, and your missiles and turrets, you're like, oh, this is taking forever. I wish I had rockets. And that only works, well, I mean, that's where once you get enough money and have equipment sitting and switch it for the missions.
Yeah. I'm not really at that point.
Like, I'm doing this sort of mission, I shall stick this equipment on the ship.
Yeah. It's quite... That's another thing that's quite... that's new and quite handy. Being able to save your outfit. And you can just switch between them with a click of a button. That's bloody handy. I haven't used it yet, but I can see it coming in useful. At a later
date. You don't have enough resources yet to be able to be...
No, this is the thing. I've been grinding the missions to get the money, and, like, Nemo has... He was saying yesterday he's got about 30 million in the bank because he's just been doing mining and shit, and I'm like, fuck's sake, he should have done mining. I'd have had my cruiser by now. But then... If I'd been mining, I wouldn't really have wanted a cruiser at this point, because I wouldn't need a cruiser to do combat missions and blah. So, yeah.
Also, you're wanting the Navy ships, so you need to do missions to get the standing.
Yeah, to get the stuff to get them. Totally. So,
yeah.
I want Navy ships eventually, at least.
Yeah. I just find it pleasing. I still find it hilarious that due to my diplomacy skill... The pirates that hate me most actually overall still will still talk to me. It's like, Ah, diplomacy skill, you're wonderful.
Yes.
Like, they hate my guts, but...
They'll talk to me anyway.
But I'm still in the positive overall.
Okay. Cargo delivery. Is...
But yeah, the area I was down in, you see, is just on the Amar border, so I've had some of the Amar skill stuff as well. So.
Mm-hmm. Amar, that's the ones that are lasers and things, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yeah. Most of their ships are beamed.
I was doing turret-y stuff, so yeah. Well, I'll say I've got older and lazier, so I'm heading for missile time as well.
Yeah, I like missiles. Missiles are fun.
Well, I think, yeah, missile projection is the last one I've got to get to 3.
Mm.
Then I'll get all the explorer stuff skills up to 3.
I need to get a hold of warhead upgrades still.
Hang on, warhead upgrades. Where are my skills? Engineering, gunnery, leadership, missiles. Yeah, oh no, I need to get that. I need to get that up to 3. Is that in the queue? Well, it's not. I'll have to go on later and add that to the queue.
Mm.
I've only got it at level 2.
You play warships just now, is it?
Hmm?
Are you on
I'm not playing it. I'm not playing at the moment. I'm talking to you. I saw you come on, so I was like, oh, I'll say hello.
Mm-hmm.
But yes, it's finding out, oh, I learned the skills so I can have 3 jump clones. That's handy.
Yeah, that is actually kind of useful. It's you can set up a jump clone in the corporation place and whatnot.
Yep. Well, when I move to the corporation place, I'll put my medical clone there as well, probably. And then have jump clones elsewhere.
Yeah.
And remember, buy spare augmentations for when I do have to use it. That's the expensive bit.
Take out the little ships first.
But yes, as is usual for somebody that's been playing the game off and on, yes, I have a variety of completely disparate skills for doing different things.
Oh dear, I'm taking a little bit of a pounding here.
Because I need to learn up my drones as well. Oh no, I don't. Oh no, most of them are at level 3. And worry about getting them before, after I... Because I'm moving a new bit of space, so I'll start doing missions over there as well. In between exploring.
Shit.
So I'll probably, I'm going to get a Heron to do some exploring, but I'll probably set up a smaller combat ship as well, rather than traipsing about in the cruiser all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Although it's quite fine traipsing about in the cruiser all the time, but it's a bit of a waste doing, I'm doing level 1 missions. And eventually I'll set up another mining rig.
Oh, balls! I
kept the equipment off the ships and just sold the ships, so I just transport everything, so, yeah.
I might need to make a run for it.
Yes, your shield is not looking healthy.
Oh, and my capacitor's just about run out. Although, if I can get rid of all these little ships and then get out of range of the big ones, because they don't really seem to be doing much shooting.
Yeah.
I might manage.
Yeah, turn away from the heavier ships and use your afterburner.
Mm-hmm.
Get some distance.
Yep, looks like I've managed. Sweet.
In some ways, that's what's missing on a lot of the ships, though. You know, it'd be nice to have a ship that's got primarily missiles,
mm-hmm.
but 2 turrets. Because yeah, when you get the enemy right down like you do, and then oh god, I've got to fire another missile. Where what one shot from a turret would kill it? It's like,
oh for fuck's sake, another bunch of shit just warped in. Bloody has too.
Uh huh. Yeah. That's what they do. Just turn away from them and.
These ones are getting closer.
Yeah. Yeah, this is why.
They are, however, still too far away to hit me.
Yep. So it was a bonus.
I'm alright.
Yeah, give your shield a chance to recover.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to try and take them all out. Am I getting bounty payments for these fuckers?
It's getting a bit windy here.
51. Yeah, I think I am. So I'd be as well to kill as many of them as I can. Shit, someone's too close. Can't tell what one. Just one at a time. Oh!
Careful.
That one's getting a wee bit close. Target another two.
Well, at least your shield's recovering.
Mm-hmm. That's it, I'll just try to keep it range, and then that way they can't hit me. And once I've killed them all, and hopefully no more will turn up, I'll just go and loot everything.
Yeah.
Because, loot. Come on, recharge.
Well, once you get into the game, you can start playing with all lovely shield skills as well.
Yeah.
Get your shields better.
With any luck, yeah.
Because then you use the skills and you're getting less capacitor loss and etc. etc. Yeah. And get rigs that.
Oh yeah, I've got some rigs. Capacitor
loss. It's Kaldari. It's all about the shields.
Mm-hmm. Oh, shit. Cruisers. Okay. They're sending in the bigger guns. I wonder how long I can last here.
Depends how many there are and...
Yeah.
What they're shooting.
Yeah. Just basically tag the closest one and keep it as far away as possible. I imagine this is one where you're expected to just go, oh, fuck that, and run. But, you know, that's no fun. Why would you do that?
As long as you can not have too many of them shooting at you at the same time, hopefully you'll be alright.
Destruction of one of the pirate ships alerted a nearby gang who joined in. Right. Okay.
Ah, right. I see.
So this might actually be the last of them, and if it is, we can get some loot.
They're trying to plow in and nick your ill-gotten gains.
Indeed. So, with any luck, this will be the last sort of spawn. Hey, what cruiser am I aiming for? Probably the Caracal, to be honest.
Yeah, Kaldaris. We like the Caracals.
I like the missile boats, yes. But it's just.
Although, despite disadvantages,
I really like the MOA as well.
If I do set up a mining ship, I am still tempted by having an Osprey as well.
uh, What's the smallest?
I remember having fun in my Osprey while mining. As I say, people coming in to attack you and go, oh shit, it's not just a mining ship. It's a cruiser. Takes longer to mine, but...
Mm-hmm. It does.
Yeah.
You have a like bit of security because you're in a big armored ship.
Mm. In all honesty, long term, though, I'm looking for getting my Raven back. But that's very much long term.
What, not a dreadnought?
Oh, well, maybe eventually, but certainly not anytime soon. Tengu. I'll need to check that one. I'm not sure what that one is. See, all these new ships and things, it's... A module
has run out of charge. Well, in my case, it's not the fact that... I mean, a lot of the ships are still the same as what I've played before, but it's just... Yeah, I haven't played for a year. I have forgotten all the Eve stuff. I've been refreshing my memory over the last couple of days.
Well, no, this is it. I mean, like I say, it's been like 10 years or so since I played, so there's all these new ships and stuff. This, the Korax I'm flying just now, that's one I'd never seen before. I quite like it. It's fun. I was expecting to not have to, but to go for the turreted thing, what's called the Cormorant again, and go through it, and then move on again to the cruisers where you get my missile boats back. But I was quite pleased to find that they've got a missile based destroyer now. It's fun.
Yeah. Well, I didn't even have missile based fun frigate wise. I've got blueprints for the Condor.
Oh my goodness, this is taking a little while.
Will do, you've only got light missiles.
Yeah. I'm not sure, what are these two ships anyway?
I don't know, have a look at them.
Indeed.
Info.
Oh, holy shit! Get the fucking size of that bastard. Is that a cruiser or is that a battleship? Or battle cruiser? What's the next one up from cruisers?
I don't know, various different things up from cruisers, so, yeah.
Smack, smack.
See, I can't see properly because the Oxymoron logo's over the top of the...
Oh!
What you're shooting at.
Right. That's actually a good point. I'll adjust that in a moment.
Yeah,
oh my god!
Next to where the targeting is, yeah.
Right. Keep at range and pound them with missiles. Right, well, that's getting on with it. I'll
that's a nasty looking ship. Yes.
There, that ought to be better. Actually, I can center that for a minute. Right, position, center. No, not there. Position and top. There we go. That's that centered. That better. I've adjusted the overlay thing. Yeah, you can see what I'm targeting
and
whatnot.
Arch engraver. Yes. Yeah, I'm not familiar with
it. It's
a
cruiser. Yeah. Right. Yeah. Thank you. So yeah, cruisers take me a little while to kill.
Yeah, just don't let them get too close. Heavy missiles are not going to be pleasant on your ship.
No. Definitely not. Oh, 38% damaged. My missile launcher's damaged.
Yeah, you've been taking fire. What do you expect?
Well,
on the bright side, your shield's fully regenerated. So.
It has, yes. I don't really need the invulnerability field on, to be honest, so...
No, not unless they start hitting me again. So, yeah. You've got out of there...
But yeah, I'll let you have a dig and see what the Tengu is then.
Yeah, you've just gone out of their range, so they can't hit you. So,
oh, out of their range, yeah, I know. That was the idea.
So, yeah.
And hopefully some of these bigger ships drop some loot, and that way it'll be useful stuff.
Oh, they're almost guaranteed to have dropped something.
And that way it'll save me pennies when it comes to outfitting my own cruiser. Hey! 116 fucking kilometers away. It's gonna take me bloody ages.
Well, nobody ever said Eve was a quick game.
So we've got a small wreck.
I do remember jokingly saying, "Oh, I'm just gonna have a quick game of Eve." 4 hours later.
Yeah. Orby Raider.
Yeah, just go for the nearest stuff first and work your way across.
Totally.
Hope you've got enough cargo space.
Oh God, aye, plenty.
Oh, that was always annoying when you're still on frigates.
Mm.
You do a mission and it's like, I can't loot everything at once.
I know, I don't get enough space, it's not fair. And of course, once you've left the area, you can't really get back to it.
Well, you can drop a marker and...
I suppose you could do, yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's what I do when I'm mining as well. You drop a marker where you find some nice tasty stuff, then you can just warp straight back to it.
Oh, right. Save the wreck location. And move. How do I save a location? Oh, wait. Ah, save location. Once at 150, warp to the bookmark.
Even I remembered you to do that. That was one thing I did remember. That and the fact, of course, I've got loads of bookmarks for asteroid fields.
Well, actually, see if I do that. Hit save location. And then.
Because my bookmarks. And things then, like, you know, rich.
So if I.
Rich Veldspar and a marker, so I can just warp there.
Turn around and go that way.
And warp home again when I was mining, so yeah.
Because, yeah, I'm more than 50 kilometres out, so I'm going to be quicker going 40 odds in the other direction. Actually, I'll save that one. Wait, Corpy Raider Wreck. So it's people and places, isn't it? Places.
Yes.
Personal locations.
That's the thing. Yeah.
Right. And then I can warp to that once I'm about 140 kilometres. Cool.
It's one of the best features in the game, the bookmarking, yeah.
Orby Raider. Take the devoted off. Yes. And there we go. So 130, it shouldn't actually take me too long. That's fucking awesome. Save it, warp to a planet, and then warp back. Right. Well, I'm only 12 kilometers off of being able to warp to it, so. That'll get me closer to the rest. That's genius, thank you very much. I don't remember if I'd ever used that function before. I honestly can't remember.
Oh, that's, yeah, I used to use it all the time.
Oh, brilliant.
But it's
you can still
lose stuff. On occasion, I have come back and found somebody else.
I think I'll need to warp to a planet and then back again.
You're like, oh wait, those are my kills. Although that's just one of those things that somebody has randomly run across the wrecks. Yeah.
I did pick up.
Doesn't happen that often.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah, that's the bugger. You've left something somewhere, you go back, somebody else is trying to nab it. So you have another fight.
Yeah,
and get stuff off them too, hopefully.
Hey! There we go. Yeah, I think I was in a Dead Space complex-y type thing, so I think I had to warp away, and then away properly, and then back. Although, once I got outside the 150, I did see the warp 2 option. It just wouldn't let me warp within that area. Ah, oh, brilliant. Here we fucking go.
Hopefully lots of goodies.
Aye, with any luck, yeah. They're all a good bit closer. I think the furthest one's 50 odds out.
Yeah, so some of these people drop some really interesting things sometimes. Yeah.
I bet it'll all be shit, though. So
I don't know.
EFFEKTD. Thank you very much for that.
There might be some level 2 equipment of varying sorts.
Going with the distances they're all at, I'm not sure if there will be. I'm not sure if that was any of the big ships.
Alright.
But, like, it's worth a check. Anything that can save me pennies when it comes to outfitting a cruiser when I get it, the better.
That's it, it's money. Anything they've left, it's money.
I haven't actually
Even if you have to just reprocess it and get it.
Yeah. Okay. Small stuff, that. Small compact shield booster. Ooh. I want other people's shields boosted, I want mine boosted, damn it. Do you think I am a team player? Only non-dead space what I suggested to work. Ah, no, that's fine. It's kind of worked anyway, so it's all good as far as I'm concerned. It certainly got me a damn sight closer than sort of waiting for 10 minutes to travel that 150 kilometers or so.
Yeah, so at that point you do miss your frigate. It's like, I want a faster ship.
Heck, I don't know, this isn't too bad when you stick the afterburner on, to be honest. And when you get to the point of battleships and stuff, or cruisers even, level 2 missions are a fucking breeze anyway. You don't need to run off so far.
The fun one you see people doing is when they're in the really big ships is they destroy something and then they're off out in their shuttle to go pick everything up. You're like, bastards. Zipping around in their little ship and then going back to their big ship. You're like,
yeah. I mean, even the start point of the Dead Space wreck still closer and faster than it would have been travelling, so yeah, totally. Awesome advice. I'll need to remember that for the future.
Yeah, I've got a great big long list of bookmarks, as I say, from when I was mining.
Dead Space rules can keep you safe from ganking if you're not if you aren't sitting on the gank. Starting point, right?
Oh, and yeah, a handy thing to have when you're doing certain things is an empty cargo container.
Yeah.
Dump that at the start point, so then when a cloaked ship comes in.
That fucking wasp just flew right by me. The little bastard. I'm gonna open the window and see if it'll bugger off again.
I was reading up on the exploding stuff. I have to remember to take an empty canister with me when I'm exploding. Screw up other people in cloaked ships coming in.
I think that's a gun. Fucking thing just wee right by in front of me. You little shit.
I've got one of those insect killing lights.
Ah, right. Ooh.
Doesn't help during the day, but
yeah.
It's not the decent one with ultrasonic as well. But
I think wasps go for they're the notorious ones for fucking cans of coke and shit, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
I'm
obsessed with sugar.
I suspect that, because you know how the vape stuff sort of condenses on windows and whatnot?
Yeah.
I suspect it's in nosing at that.
VG residue.
Yep, yes. Totally. But yeah, I mean, that's it. I've been dealing with that bugger for the last 3 or 4 days, eh?
You do know the thing with glass and furniture polish, don't you?
What thing?
Clean your window so it's nice and sparkly clean, and then just get cheap furniture polish.
Uh-huh.
And put a coating of that on the window. It stops the VG sticking to the window as much.
Ah, okay. I didn't know that, no.
I see. I'm an old timer. We know these things.
You're not that much older than me, for fuck's sake. So. Oh, okay, this one's taking a little while to get to.
Yeah.
But, oh, Another skill finished. Good, good. That was... What was that? Connections training. Oh! Oh no, that was 11 hours ago. That was yesterday. Last night. It's fine. So yeah, what to train? That is the question. Small focus, pulse energy. Okay. Probably not going to use that, but never mind.
Yeah, sell it.
Warp drive active.
Yeah, it doesn't matter what online game you play.
Mm.
You loot everything and end up selling 99% of it. Yeah.
See, that's what I'm not. I'm stockpiling. See, you get drones working. What do you actually... Oh, I've got drones in my hangar, actually. Never mind, I'll check when I get there.
Basic drone, you need drones, obviously. Uh-huh. Skill. Drone navigation, drone durability, drone avionics. Drone operations, medium drone operations. I think there's ones for combat drones. Yes. Yeah, as usual, it's spread over multiple skills. So. I even got, funnily enough, mining drone operation.
Hmm.
I have seven of the 23 possible drone skills.
Right.
I need to learn my drones better as well.
I don't actually have any ships.
Cruisery stuff.
So. Yeah, I think the Caracal has a drone bay. That's why I was wondering.
Oh, yeah. Oh yes, that's why I was interested in it. I already have the drones, so yeah. But I'd already been using an Osprey anyway, so
yeah.
And it had a four drone bay, so
yes. There we go.
Another so as I say, again. You know, if I end up guarding one of our mining compatriots.
Mm.
I could do a bit of mining on the side while I'm cruising about guarding the area.
Oh, nice! I did get bounties for some of those kills.
Send out my mining drones and grab some.
Yeah, well, that's what I was thinking. Either having mining drones or a couple of combat drones or something will probably be... God damn it, what's with the shit payout on these missions?
Yeah, well, I mean, I've already got both types of drones. So
fly over, ambush them.
Eventually, right. I'll be looking at, of course, getting the... nicer drones.
Yeah. Now, oh yeah, I said I have drones in my...
Because, see, the ones I've got at the minute are mainly recycled from wrecking other people's ships.
This is it. The drones I've got are just light drone operation, drone level 3. Medium drone. Light drone. Medium drone. Heavy drone, fuck's sake. Okay, so I need drones up at level 5 and another skill to go with it.
Well,
Volume 5.
I've only got my main drone skill at 4 at the minute, and I was using drones. Okay, not 100% brilliantly, but I was still able to use them well enough.
Where'd it go? There. What's the...
Because, yeah, you can't train everything at the one time much as you'd like to, so, yeah.
Where do you find the... Because, you know, there's a transmission... So, volume's 5, so it could take 2 light drones in the Caracal. But where's the bandwidth requirement hiding?
Oh God, I can't remember.
Ah, there it is. 5. So yeah, I could take 2 light drones in the Caracal. That would be probably quite handy. So if I get drones up to level 3, and then I'll need light drone operation as well. So I'll have a look. See if I can find that. No. Skills. Not fucking drones. Hmm. Light drone operation, there it is. Oh! 499, any in this station? No. 12 jumps, fuck that. There's 2 jumps. Oh, there's 1 jump. Ah, and Jitta, that'll do. Oh, Christ, that's 40,000 more. Yeah, I think I'll grab that one that's 2 jumps out. Sogo State Workout. Yes, I've got stuff there already. That will do nicely. spec for a drone that's good counter to the normal enemies for the missions you're doing, race-wise. I was thinking light drones, because I won't be using drones until I get into the Caracal, so I figured the light drones, they'll be helpful for frigates. Because heavy missiles, obviously, they've got a harder time. And if I've got 2 drones, and, say, a light missile or something... Aye, drones can't take a backseat. Yeah, true. I'm not planning. I'll get the absolute basics for flying them, and that'll be it. Pretty much.
Yeah, that's what I did. Yeah. I say I haven't got. I haven't got too many of the drone skills.
But yeah, if
enough to use them basically.
And, aye. Yeah. If I get a Caracal, it can take the 2 light drones, and I'll fit 1, maybe 2 light launchers, and then that way I can have the rest as heavy launchers, and I'm not crippling myself against frigates and things.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's kind of long term. I want to have... I literally have enough to buy a Caracal right now, but I haven't got enough to outfit it. I'm going to need at least 20 million? Probably?
Something like that, yeah.
I would imagine. That's,
and yeah, plus worry about 12. Getting higher spec gear later. Yes.
Yeah. Now...
Yeah, even the launchers, reasonable ones are 500,000 each, so yeah.
Shield capacity. 5 hour grid needs. Right, I think I'll get capacity up to 3 there. So that gives me a day and 8 hours. So tomorrow at 5:45. That will do nicely. Just double check my heavy missile skills though. 2. Yeah, I can go with that for the moment. So yeah, I think I'm pretty much set for the Caracal. I just need the money to get one. Did I take that? I did. Right, off we pop.
Well, that's it. Once I move to the new location, I'll be getting one.
Yeah. So there we go.
It's just deciding what equipment I want on it. For it, should I say.
On what?
The Caracal.
Ah, are you going to start doing the NPC missions as well, or are you?
Yeah. Well, I'm going to move to a new location, so yeah, I'll have to find new agents and the like. So yeah, and start going through the stuff.
Well, at least it won't take if you've already got the.
I'll buy lighter ships as well.
Yeah, I mean, if you've already got diplomacy and the connections and whatnot, then at least it won't take long getting through the level ones. Some basic drone skilling
won't take any time at
useful.
All. Yeah.
Yes. Well, that's what I'm thinking. If I get my primary fucking stuff done, excuse me, for drones, so that I can use them, and then once I've got the cruiser up to a sort of acceptable level, I'll pop a couple extra drone skills in. Mm-hmm. Holy hell, quite a lot of these. 2, 3, 4. 2 missiles each, boys. And you can have 1. Now they can't hit me because I'm a good distance away yet. Another couple of shots, most of them should be dead.
Oh, I meant to ask. Yeah, I haven't looked. Is the corporate headquarters still in Caldari space?
I don't know. I haven't been there, and... I
suppose we'll have to go and look.
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
Well, it's a good idea of then us both going there. So at least we, you know, you can... Well, no. It's not so important for you. But as I say, I'm going to move my medical clone there and then set up some jump clones in places that I fancy having a dodder about in. Before I leave the area I'm in, I might go to one of the... I might pop by the main system and put a jump clone there. Yeah. Back to the centre of Caldari space, as it were.
Yeah.
I have to pass through that anyway to get down to where the new base is going to be. So yeah, let's leave a jump clone and...
There we go.
So I'll reload all my shit while I'm on the way. I've got a bit.
Yeah. Muted my microphone before having a bit throat clear.
Oh, worse one than your, when you're streaming, that unexpected sneeze.
Oh, twofold. Happens now and again, yep.
You deafen the audience, and you end up hitting your screen.
No, my monitor! Where's the cloth?
Ah, I know, totally. Just give it a white big splatter on the camera or something.
Well, the way my room is, and the way the computer's set up, very first thing in the morning, just after dawn, the light streams in the window and hits flat onto the monitor. So yeah, wiping the screen first thing in the morning and getting all the marks off it.
Do kind of have a similar issue, yeah.
Because yeah, my screen is literally, when I'm sitting at my screen, the window is almost directly behind me. It's the only way I could set up my desk, so. Yeah. I have a giant L-shaped desk.
Forgot to repair my thing. 47
kilometers. Oh, yeah, your plan to build yourself a little flight chair.
Yeah, well, I'd quite like to, but I have not got the ability or skill to do anything like that, to be honest.
Well, there are other ways of doing it.
I could get my dad to help once he retires, because dad actually teaches,
The best way to see what other people have done is just put in Elite Dangerous Gamer setup.
Oh yeah, yeah, that's where I found it. Have done.
Yeah.
I haven't played Elite in ages, but I keep an eye on the forums.
No,
and
just look, do an image search and you can see.
Oh yeah, right enough, fine.
There's people who have just used, like, computer desks, taking the top off.
Yeah.
And just kept the steel tubing and just, you know, put uprights on to attach the monitors to. And
yeah. And I've seen the whole office chair adapted to, you know, put a couple of Visa mounts on the arms of it, and you can mount your, the flight stick and whatnot on.
Yeah.
Which is nice, and I might do that, just for simplicity's sake.
Well, this is why I've got an L-shaped desk. Well, one of the reasons, that and, you know. Off on my right hand side I have the mixer I use.
Yeah. One bit mixer. Of loot. That's
and
ridiculous.
Right next to that, just where my arm can comfortably sit is my flight stick. So yeah.
Well, my desk's actually relatively, it's got a nice big wide keyboard tray on it, so I can flip my throttle on the left, and if I move the mouse up onto the main desk where the monitor is and the flight stick down, it fits nicely in with the keyboard in between.
I don't
so
have
it's
one
not
of these
bad, but
I don't have one of these posh flight sticks with a separate throttle.
You see, that's just
I just use the keyboard because I need to have my hand on the keyboard anyway.
No, that's peasant behaviour. Hang on, I'll see if I can.
Peasant behaviour. It is the T16,000 I've got.
flight stick's down there. Throttle, rather. And. Yeah. The flight stick sitting over there.
Is it the Warthog flight stick you've got?
No, it's the X-52 Pro.
Alright. Have you seen the Thrustmaster Warthog?
Oh, aye. A friend across the road's got one.
My God, it looks like it.
It's
you could kill people with it.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
Beat them to death and then go back to playing.
Absolutely.
Because it's made out of metal.
Uh-huh. It's a lovely bit of kit.
I've got the Warthog's cheap little brother. I've got the T-16000.
Aye.
But it's still got the Hall Effect sensors.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah.
But no, I mean, the Warthog is gorgeous and it looks really nice.
Well, if... Yeah, I mean,
it's extremely expensive.
Yeah, the handling with the magnetic sensors is just amazing.
Mm-hmm. The X-52 Pro's got all that as well.
Yeah.
Although, the way they have
it is the calibrating it for a new game.
Yeah.
Forever.
The way they've got it set up, the Now, what is it called? There's a name for the way that the X-52 is set up. It does use the same Hall sensors and stuff.
Uh-huh.
But the way that it's set up is that it's got a... You know how the sensitivity sort of thing, you can get it on a curve where it's more sensitive toward the centre than it is towards the outside? That's the way the X-52 is. Whereas the Warthog has the straight, you know, it's the same sensitivity, as it were, you know. The same amount of movement all the way through. Although you can change it, yeah.
Yes, I was going to say, I've got curves when I'm playing Elite on mine.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
You can change it on the Warthog, you can't change it on the X-52 because of the way the sensors are designed on the inside.
Ah, right, I see.
Well, you can change it if you open it up and...
fiddle with it.
Aye. I think you swap the position of the magnets.
Yeah.
Relative to the sensors.
Well, I mean, I went with it.
A straight line sensitivity?
I went with the T-16000 because it was only 35 quid. So.
Yeah, they're not heavily expensive.
You can't really beat that for... That's definitely the lowest price Hall sensor.
Yeah, it is. It's actually... No, that Thrustmaster one, it's really cost-effective and it's a really good little kit. But yeah, I like to have a sensor throttle.
A lot of people complain it's big, but I've got big hands, so it's fine for me.
That's the other nice thing with the X-52, it's all adjustable, so you can move the handrest and all the rest of it.
Yeah. End of the day, if I really wanted custom, I know how I'd just get epoxy resin and make a custom hand grip.
Yeah, you could do. It's an awful lot of effort, though.
No, not really.
This is it. I'd love to. That's my whole problem. I'd love to be able to build my own computer desk and customize it, and then my own chair and all the rest of it. But I'm also a lazy shit, so you know.
I just get things in my head and go and do them.
Yeah, nah, I'm not like that. Yeah, I get things in my head and go, God, that'd be really cool, and that's how I'd do
I had a traditional straight desk. But I was using a two-monitor setup, and for broadcasting, it's nice to have more space at one side than, you know. And yeah, so I just added an L to the side of the desk. So I'm like, right, I've just increased my desk space. Woohoo! Oh, and lowered it.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually attached to the wall. I've lived here for years, and the previous previous tenant, shall we say, who was the previous owner, had attached this. It's not fancy desk material, it's just plywood, thick plywood. But he just attached it to the wall, used it as a desk. And it wasn't until last year that I realised, you know, if I was gaming for a long time, it's like, yeah, my arm keeps getting, you know, it's quite stiff. I figured out it was 2 inches higher than a normal desk. I was like, my arm's sitting at a weird angle.
Now it all makes sense.
It's like a few days ago I put my monitor height up a couple of inches. Just playing World of Warships, I was looking down at the bottom of the screen a lot.
Yeah.
Because when you're in third person, the ship's at the bottom of the screen.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, for dodging torpedoes.
Yeah.
So yeah, I jacked my monitors up a couple of inches. So I'm not having to look down.
Oh fucking hell, more of the bastards just warped in. Seriously.
Get used to it. This is what happens. Imagine what it's going to be like once you get up to level 3. It's wave after wave. Yeah, I wonder what TV channels they get on their dishes.
Mighty big dishes, so I imagine they get all the channels.
Yeah, oh, can't you stop one and ask, you know, what channels do you...
Or
at right. least your shields are
kinda holding up
nicely.
Kinda being the operative word there. I need to get these very quickly.
Somebody said it in chat. There are probably named ships that are more important than others, and when you kill it, it brings in the next wave.
Aye, that's probably it, yep. Oh, come on! Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck! Right, time to go. Fucking warp!
Afterburner. Get some distance.
Yeah, I'm warping already. Come on, run, fucking go!
Still up, can be.
No, it isn't.
Oh, I forgot, yeah.
You're a little
bit
behind.
I'm talking to you, but the stream's a little bit behind. Yeah.
Uh-huh, Jesus.
Well, as long as you get away with half your hull.
Just give it a minute.
It's not that expensive to repair. Yeah.
Just give it a minute, you'll see how much you got away with. Fuck's sake! Kroll sends out a distress signal as he was attacked.
Yeah. Yeah, watch out for them named buggers.
Jesus! Fucking hell!
See, you went all gung-ho again. I'm not paying attention. Doesn't help I was distracting you with joystick talk.
Yeah. Repair all. Yes, of course I do. That was a close one. Now, while I'm here... Oh no, I'm quicker fucking loading all my ammo while I'm in space. I'm alright for my rockets. Okay, all good. Phew! Jesus, that was close.
How much is the repair bill?
47,000. It's reasonable enough.
That's not bad.
It's better than getting blown to bits and having to spend 2 hours refitting a damn ship.
Yeah, I'll just remind you again. Yeah, shield skills.
They're in the queue. Watch this, I'll use the acceleration gate and it'll warp me in. How much is... That's a good question, actually. How much do I have at the moment? Wow! 16 million! That jumped hell of a fucking quickly.
Well, you killed an awful lot of guys just recently.
Shit! Somebody deposited cash into my account. Fucking hell.
Aww.
Thank you very much, whoever did that. In-game Cyrix. Should help with the grind, oh my god, thank you very much. Oh crap! They're right on top of me! Get the afterburner on! Get out of here! Son of a bitch! 4. Right, and 1, 2, 3. 4, you have 4, you have 3. I thought, oh my god, there must have been heaps of bounties on those ships that I just killed, but... Ah, wicked. Yes, it's somebody deserves special treatment and shit. Because, wow.
Yeah. That's a big chunk towards your cruiser.
It certainly bloody is. Right. Let's get some shield charge done. And shoot that guy. I'm at 29 fucking columns. Oh, they've got missiles too. That's what's the problem. Okay.
Yeah.
So it's just a case of...
You haven't got any jamming, have you?
No, I don't. It's just a case of whittling these buggers down, because the more of them I can get rid of, the less damage that I'm going to be receiving.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Shit. Right, I'm just gonna have to take a few hits. I think I can, though, so it's not too bad. What we'll do is head back that way now. Because these are gonna be dead in a second, and... Come on, die, damn it. Yay! There we go! I got it that time. For that, Callagher, thank you very much, man. I was... Wow. Thank you very much. Yes, Ken's mama, I am in the Korax. Yes. Oh, that was scary and stressful. But I made it. Yeah, I know I've got to cap out. I've seen that coming.
But you're one of them gung-ho type Kaldari. You're supposed to like the excitement.
Well, yeah, you know.
Not like us scientists.
Get the heart pumping a wee bit, you know. So, yes, I've forgotten the in-game name again. Sorry. Oh my fuck! Vardak! Seriously? Oh my god! Thanks! I'll be going to get that cruiser now, I guess. Jesus! Wow! You did! Yes, you definitely did! Just wow, that's like 2 weeks worth of grinding for me or something. That's ridiculous. Thank you so much. Just wow. And someone else did as well with another just fuck. And someone else did 5 as well. Cyrix. Okay. What can I say? That's... Damn very much. Do you see that there, Benny?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm jealous. I'm jealous, but then I have, like, over 80 million. So, yeah.
I'm speechless. That was thoroughly fucking awesome. Thank you. That was yourself, F. Right, cool. No, thank you very much for that as well, because that actually pushed me over the point of going, oh, maybe I can go get one now. But yes, that's just... I hated the early grind. I can't actually get into level 3 missions just now.
So how
I don't think.
How much is it actually worth for out. Me not to tell Talk that this just...
you can tell him. Assuming he's not watching, obviously.
Yeah. Mr. Corporate. He'll be wanting a cut for the corporation.
You know, that wouldn't surprise me, but It's not happening. It's mine! It's all mine! So, a nice payout from Helms and Eve Turner. Ah, cool.
You've jumped ahead of me money-wise now.
I think lucky I've jumped swine. Ahead of all of you.
Yeah. So, I'm way, way, way ahead of you skill-wise. So,
Eve Tournament team practice. Oh, is that the... Is there PvP tournaments and shit still happen here and there then? Yeah. I was never involved in any of them, but I remember... I do vaguely remember reading about them back 10 years ago when I did play. Properly, or, well, when I had my real... actually... I should check the Eve support and see if I've got my old character back as well.
Yeah, that would be nice.
See, I don't know if we'll go back to using it, though. Because...
Well, it's handy if you want to go and do other stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, because, yeah, I always like having an alt to
a bit with. That's it. I can't really afford, like, to run sort of two accounts. That would just be daft. But it would be nice to be able to go on and see what I had. The Alliance tournaments, they happen every year. 3 billion! Oh, Jesus! Wow! That's nice. That's just for helping them too. My goodness, I can't imagine what the actual tournament win would be. Yeah, that's the Eve, NT and Fight Club, not the main Alliance tournament. Right. Ooh, there's another drone. But yes, I was never involved in any of the tournaments and stuff back in the day. I should get a mobile tractor unit. Yeah, I really think I should. You're not the first person to say that. Cleunai? However you pronounce it, I hope it's not too far wrong. What was I saying? Yeah, the tractor unit. That's what I was saying. You're not the first person to say that. Somebody was telling me yesterday you really need to get one of those. I will have a look when I get back to a starbase. Wow. What the hell? What am I going to do with that? Just, wow.
Get a really, really nice cruiser and all the really nice gear for it.
It feels like such a waste, though, with that much. You should be going for a battle cruiser or something, but... Nah, they're really expensive,
aren't they? You don't have the skills
for it, so. But, yeah, indeed, I don't, so, you know. It feels, to use, like, a tenth of that, just for... It feels like it's not doing it justice.
Well, say, I'd already been thinking long-term and started training up battleships.
Oh, yeah, I mean, that's... That's my bag. As well, it were.
I already have Kaldari Battlecruiser at rank 3.
That was what I did.
Rank 6, level 3, yeah.
With the corporation that I used to be with, I just flew combat mission stuff and protected the miners and whatnot, and ratting and various bits and pieces like that. So yeah, the combat end of it's always been my thing. I helped out now and again with mining, but I didn't have the skills trained for it, really. And I have some industry skills and production skills and whatnot on this character, just to help out. Because, you know, if it's not going to be...
Well, I have joined the corporation with a wide variety of skills. Mm-hmm. See, I've got over... I'm up to 3,199,000... Hidden rapidly towards 200,000 skill points.
I don't even know how many skill points I've got.
I got tons of skills.
Where's the total?
not there. The character sheet. Yeah,
is it?
Up at the top.
That one.
Well, I say I'm not in game, I'm just looking at Evemon, so yeah.
It does give you, like, total skill points somewhere, doesn't it?
Yeah, it should do. Hang on, I'll log in briefly. I'm sure it's right in the top section of the character sheet.
Bounty, security status. Oh!
No, in the blurb right at the top, next to the portrait. I think.
Oh, there, right, I see it now, 684,467.
Yeah, I'm well ahead, I think I'm a wee bit ahead of you on skills.
Just a spot. I think most people probably
are. You jumped ahead of me in the money, but I've got the skills to use this stuff.
But yeah, I mean, I honestly can't remember my 10-year-old character details. Yeah. I must have been about a couple of million skill points, though.
Well, yeah, I mean, I'd say I'm quite impressed at how advanced my character is, considering I was only playing it for a month every year for the free. In a couple of months, I'd paid for it even there. So.
But yes, I mean, my original Eve character is the whole reason that I went to a Gmail account and whatnot for everything that I use now, pretty much. In that, my original Eve character was in an old ISP.
Yeah.
Account, and obviously when we moved from Glasgow area back up to Alness here, the account was shut down and because we didn't have internet up here for like a couple of months. By the time I actually got back online, I couldn't get into the account anymore to recover all my shit.
I'm impressed that Alness has internet these days.
Oh, very funny. Got quite decent internet, thanks very much. Wanderer. I have asked them to recover the account. I've given them as much as I can. Unfortunately, that didn't include things like the last four digits of the credit card, because that credit card as well was over 10-year-old. No paperwork left for that at all. So they've sent it on to a team, and I've given them as much of some specialised team. They said account team or something. And they've said they'll see what they can do, but I haven't heard back from them yet. But they did say it could take a while. So,
see, I was always a computer type person, so I knew in advance to have a universal email account.
Yeah.
So when the internet when it was set up and the internet got invented, I ended up with a Hotmail account. So.
I've got an old Hotmail account as well, which I really should have used.
I've actually got, I think I've got three Hotmail accounts now.
Eh? Wait a minute.
For different things. I use Outlook extensively for my email, because, damn, I've got a lot of email accounts.
Oh, god damn it. I didn't collect the... I thought the thing I collected, that Krull DNA thing... I thought that was the mission objective. It's not. It's something else. You bloody idiot. Yeah, digging accounts that old, I expect, will take some time. Yeah, totally. Ah, that's good.
Wanderer, CCP. I mean, everything's on one server, and they keep everything.
They keep everything, which is great. But, on a related note, that's one of the reasons that I'm never going to play any Sony online entertainment games ever again. Fuck them.
Oh god, Sony's... setups are ridiculous.
I played PlanetSide 2. I played PlanetSide, the original one.
Customer services and they're like, oh, we can't help you with that. It's a different system. You're like...
Must have been about a year that I played that for.
Company. What do you mean?
I need to destroy it. Cool. I played PlanetSide for, I don't know, about a year, maybe? Before I started playing World of Warcraft, so that would have been way back 2003 through to 2004. And when PlanetSide 2 came out, I played it for a bit and then left, and then came back again and played it probably for about 6 months, and actually spent some cash on it. I had the whatever they call it, the premium account or whatever they were calling it at the time, and spent some money on skills and some, items and stuff. Just a wee top up on the sort of monthly stipend that they give you.
Yeah.
An extra couple of quid to build that up to get a couple of bits and pieces. I tried to go back to PlanetSide 2 last month. Now, the last time I played it, it must have been about a year, maybe a year and a half, possibly even 2 years ago, when I actually played it properly. Now, what am I after? Slave pens. Where's this pleasure hub? There it is. So...
It's a pleasure, Hab. Are you going to velour coat your missiles?
When I went back to play it a couple of months ago, it turns out they changed their... their account management or something? Company? Yeah. And because they changed their account management company, or whatever it is... Why am I going away from that? I was wanting to approach it. Stupid thing. That's a funny little cat face thing. When I went back to play it and I said to them, look, sent them an email with all the details that they needed, because I still have all the details, obviously. It wasn't that long ago that I played it and paid and so on and so forth. And they basically told me to piss off. We haven't got any of the information, get lost. Okay, that's fucking charming, that is, thanks. So yes, on that note, I will never ever, 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 ever play Sony Online Entertainment game again.
Yeah,
and I will
tell
everybody
like,
who cares to listen about how shit they are.
Sony, like the good corporation they are, farm out the contracts to the cheapest subcontractor. And then a couple of years later, oh, this other contractor's cheaper. Yeah, we'll move to them.
So,
and that means they've fallen out with the first company who refused to give them the records, and this is one reason why Sony keep getting hacked to hell.
I closed my chat
because they keep
this is it. If they're going to dick people around, then you know, don't be surprised if people retaliate. To be honest, so yes, never going near Sony Online again, bunch of bastards.
Don't think I've got any Sony games at the minute.
No, I don't, obviously. But yes, I was most impressed with that, because I through the course of the subscription and the time it spent on the character and the extra bits and pieces I put in, you know, that probably like 100, maybe a couple of hundred quid. That's not nothing, you know.
No.
So yeah, it's a not impressed, and I will never touch Sony Online Entertainment ever again. But I like their phones, to be fair, so you know. But that's a completely different division, so fuck it.
Well,
I can reconcile that one.
Oh, I'm a real cheapskate. I've got a Lenovo phone.
All right.
I've got one of them Lenovo K3 Notes.
I didn't know they did phones.
They don't match over here, but. Mine's Chinese, so, you know. It's people, you know, you get them on eBay, you get imported, and you just buy them on eBay. And then stick your own ROM on to get rid of all the Chinese stuff. It's... I've got an octa-core phone. 16 gigs of memory. Yeah, it's got a few features that are annoying, but... It's a high-spec phone for £100 rather than £400. Quick, somebody go on.
Ferry, do wasps lay eggs or something?
No, they make hives.
They make hives.
And lay eggs in the hives for the, you know, they have a queen. They're insects. Yeah, check. Wait till he's back on. Probably can't see through the screen.
That wasp that I was telling you about earlier has just been stalking Karen in the bathroom.
If you check under your eaves and in the attic, see if they're building a nest.
Well, it's only the one that's been floating about, so I doubt it. Yeah. If it was any more than that, I know it's big, but it's harmless. It's fine. Oh dear.
I'll tell you, one of the funniest things I ever saw was back when I was still living at home with my dad. Mm-hmm. The council were replacing the windows, and there's a wasp nest up in the eaves.
Very
and
nice.
We just left it because we're my dad and my family, We're from the countryside. We don't give
a
shit.
Yeah, we don't bother about these things.
That's wasps.
Totally.
That's fine. As long as the nest didn't get too big. You know. So, the workmen disturbed the wasps.
Mm-hmm.
And all these middle-aged guys running about screaming like little girls. Me and my dad going, what? It's suddenly wasps. You know.
Level 3 distribution.
So, yeah, they wouldn't come back. My dad went and got a blowtorch and burned the nest.
Burned it down. I could do level 3 distribution missions, but they're not
coming. Yeah, it was like a dozen middle-aged guys running about.
Mm-hmm.
If it had been the days of smartphones, that would have been on YouTube in the next
Oh yeah, year. Totally. Totally, totally.
Look at these big burly blokes. They're big burly girlies.
Yeah. Well, best level 2 Kaldari. Best level 2 mission. Agent. Best EVE agents. Kaldari ships from 2. Because, yeah, there's different quality of agents as well, isn't there?
Yep.
Some that give you better missions or better payouts than others.
And, yeah, different divisions in corporations.
I want to stick with the Kaldari Navy, obviously. Because...
Yeah. I think even they have some slight division of what type of agent it is. You know, security, logistics, all that kind of stuff. Because even the Navy does all that kind of stuff. So, I can't remember exactly. But, yeah. Yeah, different agents give you different types of missions.
Dinged. Ah,
okay, as I say, I've got a ton of agents. I will be leaving Wald behind to head towards corporation space. It won't take me long to build up new agents. And I say I'm gonna plan to leave a jump clone.
Mm-hmm. No, not that. How do we advance? Hubs. Oh, that one looks helpful. Hang on. Search.com. Okay. Oh, there's a site called EVEAgents.com. Right, division? No, faction first. Kaldari state. Security missions. Level 2. Research skill? Do you get research?
Missions? Yeah.
Kaldari Navy. Storyline. Okay, search with those. Acquired standings. Cater service. Agent type. Basic agent. Are these all basic? I'm not sure. Okay. That doesn't actually seem to be. There's no. At least. Oh, wait! L2Q20. Quality 20? Or does that just mean it's a level 2? It's hard to tell. I'll just stick with it. Oh, unless it's a queen. I don't think it would be a queen wasp, but it was quite big, but I'm going to check that. Sorry, I'd missed the chat for a minute there. I was googling something.
You went all googly-eyed, yes.
How can you recognise queen wasp?
Because they're even more aggressive than normal. No, that doesn't help. They are even more aggressive.
Are they not smaller? Aren't they? Sure.
I can't remember. Years since I had to deal with wasps.
Yeah.
I live in a flat, so I'm quite high up, so we don't get them in here quite very often. So.
I don't think it was a queen wasp. No. No, it was definitely just a drone. Yep. So yeah, we're okay. No hives. Being built nearby. Hopefully. Right,
still check for them though, just in case.
on the extreme generosity of Vordak, I can actually go buy a cruiser now and outfit it. So what I'm going to do is cheat.
Then you'll definitely be able to come and escort me. Yeah,
totally. and I'm going to find a decent fitting first before I go and buy one. Get a rough idea what I'm actually doing. I know a couple of heavy missiles and stuff, but no. Fittings.
And you're at the naval assembly plant, which is really handy for the equipment. Because they'll have a lot of the stuff you need to put on the ship.
Uh-huh.
There's a Navy logistics place not far away as well from where you are, I think.
Rapid light missile launchers. Heavy missiles. Heavy assault missiles. Oh my god, there's so many fitting options for these.
Uh-huh.
It's an NNITH. Exploder, I guess? Don't know. Yeah, maybe. Oh my god, so many options. On the Eve University website, there's a fitting section for...
Yeah.
So what are they suggesting? Heavy missile launchers. It's a 10mn afterburner. Adaptive invulnerability field. EM ward. Oh, and two shield extenders, rather than having a booster. Right.
Your ship's got a lot more power, so yeah.
Shield power relays and ballistic control system. Couple of drones. Inferno heavy missile. Medium core defense field purgers for the rigs.
Yeah.
Okay. I suppose that gets your passive shield tank up, because how does it work again? The more your shield and the lower the recharge, the more per second, or whatever, every 6 seconds it recharges, really? Whatever it is. That your shield will tick over. So the bigger the main shield, the more regen, the more passive regen it has. So I can see why they've got that one in there. But yeah, that does kind of make sense. And the other fittings are fairly similar. Adaptive invulnerability to regen. That one's just got heavy missile launchers. Micro heavy missile launcher. RLMM? That. Ah! Rapid light missile launcher. Right. Or one with light missiles. Or heavy assault missiles. Heavy assault, slightly different. That's actually got a warp scrambler and a web. But I don't really want to be getting into range of stuff to be webbing or scrambling, because I'm not really going out of my way to PvP at the moment, where that will become important. So, I think I'll just go with the heavy missiles and the two drones. I might switch one of the heavy missiles for, Reddit, right, okay, yeah, I'll give that a look. Reddit
for the young and trendy people.
Yeah. I use Reddit now and again.
Yeah, I've got a Reddit account as well.
But a semi-AFK Karavkal for level 2. The first one that comes up on Google. How old is this? 7 months. September. Yeah, that one'll do. Right, messing around EFT. Two missile guidance enhancers, two missile guidance computers, three medium rocket fuel cache rigs, five heavy missile launchers. With auto-targeting heavy missile. Oh, right, okay. allow you to snipe from 82 kilometers. Jesus. I mean, okay. If you want a semi-AFK fitted with drones, you know, you could get a fucking drone boat like a Vexor, load it up with mediums and literally go buy groceries while it kills everything. Brilliant. I love Reddit. It's so much fun sometimes.
And other times you want to pull your eyes out.
Yeah. It doesn't even actually give you the details of a fit there. That's terrible. I think I'm going to have... These are mostly coming up with R Newbies. Or Eve Noobs, whatever it is. Ah, there's one. On the Reddit fittings page.
You can use the search features, you know.
Ah, I know.
How long ago something was put in.
I know, but... Dick, man.
Use a search term, you know.
Swap the hardeners. Appropriate, yeah. Okay, here we go. Yeah, that's actually fairly similar. The one that's showing up on the Eve University site. So that's not bad. That's cool. Aye, some of the Eve Uni kit outs are sub-2010. Wow. Yeah, I did notice that. There was something... Battle Clinic? Is that? Not sure what Battle Clinic is. I did notice that on Eve Wiki, that there's something called Damage Control 2, which is a low slot item, but I couldn't find any in the game itself when I was running through the build for it. So yeah, that's probably why. Now, let's see if I can get everything in my item hanger into... Oh no, I'm in perimeter anyway, aren't I? Yeah. So, select all. Actually, you know what? I'm kind of curious. Select all of that. Oh god, that's lots. No, I can't transfer everything in this ship. Take the Scourge out, put everything into my item hanger. And sort. Stack. Sort by type first. So I've got modules at the top. Think. Do I? Sort by type. Yeah, that's it. Okay, so ammo at the top. It's at the bottom. Cool. Right, there we go. Jesus gods, I've got quite a bit of stuff in this item hanger. Ridiculous. Okay. So. Ah. Maybe that's what I was doing wrong. Cool, nice one, Calcron, thank you. Region show only available. I do actually have that set. I'm going to try that. What was it called? It was damage control. Armor warfare link. Ah, there it is. Damage control 1, right. Okay, so it does exist. Okay, so containment field emitters and redundancy mitigate the impact of crit system damage. Grants a bonus to resistance for shield, armor, and hull. One can be fit at any given time. Wow! A 7.5% damage day resistance boost. That's not actually bad. And 30% for the hull. That's pretty decent. And there's some over at Jet as well. Yay! Groovy. Right, I'm going to figure out buying a new ship in a minute. I'm going to nip to the loo first. Bye, anew. Now that's just the weirdest thing to occur to someone. Passive slots, your hull gets 60% resist. Ah, okay, nice. Something just bizarre occurred to me. Ignore the fact I was going to the toilet while it occurred to me, but I know how I can make a proper tribute to the folks that donated me ISK there, which is Syrix and Vordak. I'm going to nail my new Caracal after them. There. And that way I won't ever forget their generosity, because I'll have it named the SS Syrix Vordak. Yeah, that works, doesn't it? There we go. It's the least I can do. Surely.
Shows how much I've forgotten, though, because, yeah, he mentioned that, and I went and looked, and yeah, one of the pieces of equipment I've got is a damage control.
See, that's the thing. Yesterday, I seen it on I seen it on a ship build I was looking at.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't fly it. I need cruiser level 2. I could totally buy an AV issue, but that'll just be overkill at the moment because I've not got the skills for it.
Initially, I'll just be buying a normal Caracal because I haven't done the Navy missions. So,
So standard cruisers, Kildari.
And I haven't done the Navy missions because technically I am a scientist.
You'll have to start. So there's one available at 11. I will have that.
All the Kildari stuff I was doing was for the state.
There we go. Now,
stuff.
Think, do I go pick up the ship? Get the meta version of the modules if you can't do T2. I will. That's the named versions of modules, isn't it? So, for example, the plan is, if I can find what I'm looking for, fuck's sake. Where's turrets and bays gone?
Under ship equipment.
That's what I'm doing wrong, isn't it? I haven't got ship equipment. Oh. Fucking idiot.
Think of how it feels for me. I'm talking to you, but I'm seeing the stream like 30 seconds later.
Aye, behind. So yeah, the meta versions of the things like these limited Limos and prototype Arbalest stuff. If I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, it was Arbalest stuff I was pimping my ships out with. Mm. Yeah.
Is the Malkuth the best one, generally? Do they get better the further down the list you go, or...? Ah, I know what I need to do. I need to compare.
Yeah.
Right, now, how do I compare? Right, that's the XT thingy. How do I get the comparison thing? Ah, there we go. Prototype Arbalest, upgraded Malkuth. So,
if you've got the money,
Arbalests are best.
Remember, level 2.
So, reload time. No, not reload time. I want rate of fire. 7.6 seconds. 6.4 seconds. 6.8. Ah, it looks like the Arbalest are the best rate of fire wise, yeah.
Well, say it's Arbalests I got, so. Yeah.
Charges per cycle? Nah. Meta level. And then obviously the damage and whatnot depends on what missiles you're using anyway. So yeah, it looks like the Arbalest are the best ones. So yes, that will definitely be what's worth going for. Oh, and they're not bad. It's 150,000 each. Obviously, if I hadn't had these really, really quite generous
that's
donations.
That's only launcher ones you've gone for. You could have gone for launcher twos.
No, I haven't got the skills for the launcher twos.
Oh, yeah,
yet.
I haven't got the skills. I keep forgetting I'm way ahead of you on skills. Yeah.
Oh, where did that compare? Did I close that compare window? I did, didn't I? Yep, because I'm an idiot. Never mind.
1.6 mil! Holy crap! Why are they so expensive? Rate of fire, 12 seconds per shot. It must be the damage or something, yeah?
Damage and range, I think, yeah.
Yeah. Ah, yuck.
Something to look forward to.
Right, hang on, I have a whisper I want to, Right, how do I do that again? Hash W.
Well, at least you're getting a bit of
a result. Good god. There we go. That should have been a whisper. Good, yeah. So, Meta 4 launches the best ones besides Tech 2. Right, damage is in the ammo, not the launcher. Yep. Launchers only have rate of fire differences.
This is why I'm taking it easy.
The best...
Yeah. So much to relearn.
They are the best T1, the highest tier makes them expensive, but still cheaper than Tech 2 in some places, and fitting cost, yeah. Cool. Right, I should probably go collect the ship first, though, shouldn't I?
Yeah.
Which is assets. So, set destination. How's the trip? Relatively safe. Hey, Thilo, yes, new stream, new EVE player stream,
Woohoo, I've passed 3.2 million skill points.
Right, that's why. There, right. What am I doing? Flying. Oh, damn! No! Cancel warp. Fuck you, stupid thing. I was going to buy a shuttle or something just to ferry over, rather than leaving my Korax behind somewhere that I'm not going to be able to pick it up again if I need it. Oh, 0.3 inbound becomes dangerous, right. Excuse me. Where did I come from? It's a Navy assembly plan, isn't it? I can't even fucking remember. It's so bloody hopeless. Yes, it was Navy assembly. I'll go back and just fly my pod over to get it, I think. God, what a dumbass, man. Really.
It's not as bad as you were doing yesterday.
No. It's certainly, yesterday, how long did I have to end it? I went out. The first fucking mission that I tried to do, I get blown to fucking bits and I have to spend 2 hours refitting the bloody Korax. It's just like, yeah, that was just fucking...
I will remember... If my memory holds out, I will remember the missile thing for quite some time.
Yeah. Oh, yes, and the chaos with the fucking... rockets and missile confusion. God damn. Just, now.
Yeah, and me and Talk both making unhelpful comments to you, like, oh yeah, we got those.
Yeah.
We both have blueprints for those missiles you were using, so yeah.
Ship hangar. Yay! Okay, that's better. I'm gonna just pod ride it.
Living life on the edge.
Mm-hmm. I've got just over a half hour before the system shut down, and that's usually when I stop streaming and go and have a bit of lunch and then pick up the little one from nursery and all the rest of it, because I don't really get much peace for the rest of the day after that, because you get kids coming home from school and housework to do and all that shite. And
you're rich now, can't you afford a servant?
Well, I've left the janitors in the station, so, you know, hopefully they'll be cleaning up after me, but, you know, I think I've got 20 janitors in the station now. I should probably just sell them and be done with it, because I doubt I'm going to need them. Squarebox. Yeah. I do all have a bit of trouble remembering which icons are which still.
You think you got problems? I have actual memory, real memory issues. I opened up Eve for the first time in over a year and looked at it and went, "Oh, what's all this then?" And that's why I haven't got much done since.
Try to remind yourself. That was it. I mean, I did load up my old character, a while back, or was it a different trial account? And everything had changed so much that I just basically went into the game, I think it was a different trial account, actually. And I looked at the game and went, oh my god, what the fuck is going on? And then just didn't really go back into it. I don't think I'd recovered my old character at that point either, to be honest. But... Actually, did I?
Have you remembered to take in your pod the little pine tree to put hang on the?
Oh yeah, of course. You can't go without your. Excuse me. Oh jeez.
Fluffy dice.
Yeah. Yeah, indeed.
Grab. Well, a bigger ship. You can put more crap in your command.
Yeah, 2012. 315 Days of Eve, 2012.
Now, it's when I looked the other day and it was like, oh, I did play my 3 months last year. I was like, I completely forgot.
So that's, I mean, the I'm assuming that that's my old account, because the name is familiar, but that's the only reason I actually remember the character name as well, is because I got those emails. So,
well, as I said yesterday, that's the one bonus I've got. I always use the same character name in all different games I play, so makes remembering stuff, you know, easy. I've only got the one name to remember. Well, there's actually three character names I like using in games, so, yeah. And I've been using them for more than 10 years, so...
Oh, somebody inviting me to a conversation. Oh, go on then, just out of curiosity. Because usually when I get invited to conversations, it's someone just using the... Ah, yay! They actually said something this time. I'm going to salute. Here we go.
Yeah, I've got a contact from, I think, last year when I played.
Mm-hmm.
Some person I must have done some stuff with.
Ah, someone that knows I'm streaming. Hey.
Well, if a ship uncloaks next to your pod...
Yeah, it's... Oh, okay. don't stream while you're in your pod or something. There we go. Now, where am I now? I'm not in the right system yet. Person that convoyed you has special suit item from Eve Vegas. Alright, is that the... Ooh, cool. That is a nice suit. Very smart. How Hide the username, location, and chat. Otherwise, people might declare war on you or grief you. Ah, okay. Hide username, location, and chat. Oh, chat! I suppose chat, you can see some of the names in, can't you?
Yeah, you'll be unsurprised, Blair, and I have no intention of streaming Eve. I'll probably end up playing Eve mostly early hours of the morning where we live, so...
Source, ah, hi Brainman, yeah, thank you man. The SOE combat armor you get from, Project Discovery, right. I've done some of that Project Discovery stuff. I got it from the capsule name, right. So yeah, how would I hide them? That's the thing. I could put some of the overlay elements over it or blur some stuff maybe. But
yeah, just put a graphic over it.
Yeah. I think at this point I'm not too I'm still in the tripod and I've only been playing since the weekend or Friday night. So I think we're okay the now. I think once we actually start getting into doing proper corporation things. Oh, there he is. Hi Enyo. Oh no, it's not. That's the private chat, not the local. Idiot. That's thrown me off my train of thought. Yes, aye. Still relatively new, and I think if we get to doing any sort of corporation operations, or we go mining in low-tech or anything like that, we'll probably. I do have two screens, Calcron, yeah. The only thing is, they're not two of the same aspect ratio screens, so one's a 1920x1080, one's an old square 19-inch job. It's like 1280x1024, I think. So stretching it across screens can cause some odd behaviour with windowed mode. And then just use monitor capture for the main screen, but yeah, that would actually work, I expect. Assuming it didn't cause too much unusual behaviour with the other thing. Yeah, lost train of thought again. Never mind. I know. So I'm saying nothing. Now, how do I rename a ship? I can rename them, can't I?
Yeah.
Yes, change name. There it is. And I'll call it the SS. And I've forgotten what the SS I'm calling it again. Hang on. Because these guys need some recognition for what they have done. So it's the SS.
Cardboard boxes or banana boxes, I think.
I think it goes quite well alphabetically for that. And there's Karen shouting. And just as a wee thank you. Second. Here we go. Phew. Right, so what was I saying? Yeah, what are the boxes in the background? Yes, we do have lots of boxes because we're actually going to be moving house soon. Probably by the end of the month. Sorry about that, it's a delivery. Yay. I like when my post comes through. My American juice arrived today.
Well, it's a vape mail day.
It is vape mail day. So that's about...
Means you don't have to hunt down and kill the postman.
Yeah. Yep. It's. I wouldn't have actually heard it. I'm quite glad Karen's home today because I would have totally missed that. But yes. So we're. It's not so much that it's small room that we can't unpack. We're actually packing to move. We should be moving at the end of the month.
And you know somebody that likes bananas a lot?
No. Karen works in Morrison's. Down the road. So, basically, the
yeah, fruit boxes are the best for packing.
She's got the relevant department that have been holding the boxes for her, and so we can pack stuff, which is
I used to work in quite Intel, helpful. So similarly, when I move, it tends to be fruit boxes.
Yeah, fruit boxes really are.
They're just so much. They're so much sturdier.
They are exactly. I can't get the plastic off. Oh my god, I'm going to get so upset. There we go, that's it now. Actually, I need to fill this up not so long. I'll need to dry it out a wee bit. So yeah, it's a very crazy month for us because we've got the Motability card, daughter's disabled, so we get... it's called a mobility car. I don't know if you're all in the UK, you'll probably know what it is, but if you're not, it's part of the benefit stuff that Amy gets can be cut off and you get supplied a car with it. Curious about distribution of skill points. Aye, hang on a sec, no problem. I'll stretch that down a spot. So we've got the new one of that coming soon. Towards the end of the month, and we've just got notification from the local authority that we've been allocated a house that's actually more suitable for Amy's needs. Like, it's got various bits and pieces.
Will it be able to have fibre to the cabinet?
Yeah. All of Illness has got fibre, so we're fine. Or is it fibre? Yes, it's fibre. So we're fine that way. So we've got all this stuff happening, so it means we're actually really fucking skinches now, which is difficult, because although we get the car technically on that 3-year lease thing for free, kind of, it cuts off a bit of Amy's disability benefit stuff, but you have to put a deposit down on it, so we're saving up for that deposit just now, and obviously we need to save up to get the new house sorted out. And all the rest of the stuff. So
you're back to eating like a student again.
No. We're quite good that way because we effectively cook most things. If you know what I mean, from scratch.
That plus the fact, somebody in the house will be getting a discount card for their work.
And so. Karen's got the discount card for groceries and whatnot as well, so that helps. So it's not bad that way. It's not like we're having to live in absolute poverty to save up for
shit. Remember when you do move, get nice firm times and dates off the ISP for the engineer, if you need one. Well, they always send one these days.
Yeah.
Because, they're a pain in the ass.
I know.
BT Openreach.
You don't need to go there. I worked for them for 5 years. I know how to deal with them. It's fine.
We lost our internet here for 2 weeks. The first guys that came to fix it, fixed it long enough for them to get in their van and drive off. Literally, it was about 10 minutes after they'd gone. It all folded.
And it folded up again.
And then, of course, it takes a week for another engineer to come out and look at it again. It's like, oh, God. But back up to full speed now. I get 73 down and over 90 up. Which is not bad. And we are only 40 yards from the nearest cabinet, so, yeah.
Yeah, that's not bad.
That helps with the speed somewhat.
Yay, gotta go! Sorry, Death of Texas, I'm going too slowly through the list here. Cybernetics, it's just one.
I don't mind showing off my distribution of skill points, because if anyone's got any pointers, I'm always happy to listen. Yeah, just some basic resourcey industry stuff. Enough rigging to put some things in, because I don't know what else to get in there, to be honest. Scanning, that's just what I started with, pretty much. I don't think I've updated or improved any of them. Again, just what I started with. Shields, I have popped some of those up a bit. Socials currently, that's for the mission running, obviously, so I've popped them up a bit. Oh, back to shields, actually. Compensation's going to 3, management's going to 3, operations at 3. Upgrades and shield manipulation, I'll probably need to boost them as well. Spaceship command, I've just got things to 3 to move on to the next step for the moment. And cruiser will train to 2 later on. Targeting. Target management. Extra target per skill level up to the ship's maximum allowed number of target locks. Actually, that's something mine. Where is the maximum number of targets? 6. I can probably do 4 at a time. Which is fine. That's enough. And trade. I've just got the 2 points. Again, that's what I started with, so. But yeah, hopefully that gives you an idea of the distribution of skill points. So what was I saying? I forgot what I was talking about before I was flicking through there. No matter. Outfitting! Yes, I need to outfit this thing.
Yes. Just remember to do that before you take it for a spin. Yes.
Now, I'm just trying to move the page so I can see the chat and the thing at the same time. There, and I'm going to go with that general fitting. So, what are we needing first? Market. Excuse me. Oh, actually. Give me a minute. Nope, not inventory. Oh, what's that? Ticking for. Ah, I paid stuff, yeah.
Don't forget to insure it.
Yeah, indeed.
But wait until you fit the equipment, obviously. Okay.
Oh, and you. Thank you for thank you for the tag in the wallet bit there. It's 0, but I can see your name, so I won't forget you now. Which is all good. Now, I might actually have some of those missile launchers somewhere. I'm sure I picked one up off in one of the missions. Vindicator. Pirate faction ship. Ooh, I'll have to have a look. Is that a variation on the Caracal, or is it a completely different one? I could probably go look, actually. We've got that ship tree thing, after all. Right, so nothing there. Not there. Not there. I've got lots of stuff in perimeter. Right, here we go. Ah! Oh no, it's a torpedo launcher. And a rapid light missile launcher. Actually, that might be handy. Variation of the Megathron. Right, cool. I might just use that light missile launcher. 15 minutes.
Yeah, you're probably not going to have time to
fully. Yeah, possibly not. Missile guidance enhancer is flight time and missile velocity bonus. I think I'm wanting the damage bonus ones. That's ballistic control, if I remember right. Internal structure. Yeah. And I've got some drones kicking about. I'll just use them. Oh no, it's not janitors, it's militants that I've got. Militants, marines, and I do have janitors there as well. And yeah, I've got a couple of combat drones that I can use. And they can deal with frigates, so I can fit mostly. Ah! Heavy assault missile launcher. It's the experimental one though, so it's not as good as the Vindicator's a beast in PvP. Difficult to get away from the blaster DPS milling your ship. I haven't done much with blasters or railguns or anything. I'm very much a big fan of missiles. The experimental ain't too bad. It's only 0.4 of a second lower than the what's the one we're supposed to be going for? The Arbalest? So I might use that as well.
You just use what you've got a minute and then figure out what you want to do.
I mean, with the generosity of those two folks
you're getting some retail therapy.
Indeed, from Cyrix and Vordak, because I keep forgetting their name. I'm hopeless with names. Sorry. It's going to make things much easier to sort through and just buy the stuff to give it a really nice set. Oh, I've got an afterburner there. That'll do. The Wi-Fi. Oh, what's that? Core compensation. Oh, it's a sensor. Upgrade. Oh no, it's not. It's a warp core stabilizer. Right. And a Malkuth heavy missile launcher. Which is 14.25. Ouch, that's slow as fuck. So, right, it's not any of them. What have I got there? That's just a bunch of ships. So yeah, I haven't actually got much that I think I can use on that particular ship yet, other than I do have one medium shield extender in Kosogo? Should be there. No, it isn't. It's probably in Jeddah then. Yeah, but that's just a standard medium shield extender, so I might buy the improved ones instead.
I say you should be fine for getting hold of equipment though, because you're in the middle of Navy space.
Yeah, totally. So you don't get warp scrambled and stuck, but gives you a negative range. Ah, okay, that's what the -47 is then. So people can... you can't lock targets as far as normal, but warp scramblers have less of an effect on you. Right, cool. I do vaguely remember that stuff. Heavy assault launcher intended for use in cruiser class. Assault launchers don't possess the sheer damage dealing capability of regular heavy missile launchers. The speed and attack power lends them application across a range of tactical situations. Right, that's fine. I don't know what to go for. Heavy assault or heavy? Or rapid heavy? Launcher for battleships to counter smaller combat ships such as frigates and cruisers can only be loaded with heavy missiles. Oh my god, look at that fucking power requirement. Yeah, I really can't. I can't use rapids then, that's fine. Jesus! What is the power on this anyway? There it is. 1437. Cool. So, heavy missiles have got a much better range. Okay. What is the targeting range of this thing as well? Does it tell me here? Targeting. 63 kilometers! So, heavy missiles are longer range with a bit less DPS. Heavy assault are shorter range with more DPS. Right.
Cool. 63 kilometers is fucking insane. The targeting distance. So, right, okay, figure out... Rapid is for super fast, but the reload time's 60 seconds. Jesus, that's mental. Rapid light missiles use frigate-sized ammo, so you will apply your damage very well. They do their best. They do their DPS in burst with a long reload time in between. Okay, so in that case, one rapid light missile launcher for dealing with frigates, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 assault launchers, I think, will probably, you can get more damage with frigs. Yeah. 80 kilometers! 80 kilometers attack range! Shit! That's huge! And I thought fucking 47 with a destroyer was a lot. I think this is probably something I either have to go and do this evening or tomorrow morning and all, because it's about 8 minutes.
Take your time.
Aye, take my time, get it done properly. Can I get that back there? Yes, I can. I'm going to bookmark that so I can get back to it later. So yes, there's only 8 minutes to go, so I'll probably give it a rest there. So I might finish off outfitting the lovely Karaka. Look at it, it's so pretty. tonight or tomorrow morning. I'm honestly not too certain at this point. I'm just overwhelmed with gratitude for everybody for all the advice and the help. It should fit all your weapons as the same type and variation, so you have the same range. Ah, okay. All your DPS on the target all the time. That's actually a good point. Yeah.
Yeah, because do remember for you will have a couple of drones as well.
Yeah. Because you can still hit frigates with heavy missiles anyway, can't you?
Oh yeah.
It's just that it affects the damage they do or something.
So the little I remember, I don't remember having a problem with my heavy missile launchers when I was playing the last time. So.
Oh, that's cool. Thanks, Wander. I think I'll probably go with a heavy assault for the bit more DPS, and then boost it again with the ballistic controls in the low slots. So everybody, the absolute glorious generosity of Cyrix and Vordak, because I'm sorry I keep forgetting your names, for actually donating the money for me to get up to this point. That's absolutely fucking awesome. Thank you so much. And everybody in chat for keeping me company and for the advice. Ferry, cheers for joining on Discord.
doing anything else, so yeah.
Well, you know.
And at some point, yeah, I'm going to drag my ass over to our new corporate headquarters.
So, well, yeah. When you're ready to do so, I'll come and do you an escort.
Well, the first little bit's in fairly safe territory anyway, because I have to go through where you are.
Uh-huh.
Which is all in the Navy bases and everything, so yeah.
That should be relatively safe. And if you don't want me to stream when we're doing that, I won't.
Nah, it doesn't matter.
And
it may be only a badger, but as I say, face plasma, 200mm cannon.
Yeah.
Yeah. Frigates don't tend to like that.
It can help.
And I can mount a heavy missile launcher. So yeah.
And I've got my nano cream back. Yay! So yes, again, thank you everybody for all the advice, all the help. I'll get this new cruiser outfitted. It'll either be tonight or tomorrow. What day is this? Thursday. Yeah, I usually do stream on a Thursday evening.
So we'll either get this done tonight or tomorrow morning. And again, thank you so much for keep me company in the chat. And hopefully I'll see you again. Take care, guys. Thanks again. See ya.